This video will help walk you through the steps of assembling and installing your CMAXX dust and fume collector. These are the tools you'll need to install your CMAXX. You'll need sockets, wrenches, an impact driver, crescent wrench, pin bars, a drill, and a knife or box cutter. You will also need lifting straps and shackles, as well as a concrete hammer drill with wedge anchors. Unload the CMAXX and make sure that all parts are present. Cut the wrapping on your CMAXX and remove it. Locate the packet containing the owner's manual, which will be attached to the CMAXX door handle. If your CMAXX comes with a drum, items such as bolts will be in the drum. The differential pressure kit will also be in the drum. If your CMAXX doesn't come with a drum, these items will be packed separately. Locate the structural bolts that you'll need to assemble the support frame. Set the hopper in place and unbolt it from the wooden skids. Begin bolting the structure on. Do not tighten the bolts. You will need some flexibility while assembling. Begin with bolts on the outside of the structure, then move to the inside. Do not tighten the bolts. Shift the legs if necessary to align the bolt holes.
All your bolts are loose.
Begin bolting the X braces. Do not tighten the bolts yet. Following the video, bolt the inner X brace first. Next, bolt the outer X braces, then the outer leg points. Bolt the center points last. Please note that the structural hardware is directional. The side of the nut that locks against the washer has a raised ring. The outside of the bolt is flat and rounded. Once all the bolts are in place, you can begin tightening the structure. Start tightening at the bottom nearest the hopper and move towards the top. Tighten evenly as you work around the structure. Once all the bolts are tightened, you're ready to flip the structure upright. Use the forklift or crane to lift the structure, and then use wooden blocking to prevent scratches. Adjust the rigging as you go to keep the lifting upright. Guide the structure into its final position and set it down. Ream the corner bolt holes as shown. Ream the corner hole and the ones on each side of it. If your CMAXX is bigger than 24 cartridges, ream two holes on either side of the center hole. Apply rope caulking around the edges of the structure. Apply two strips along the inside and outside edge as shown. Make sure to overlap the strips at the corners to prevent any gaps. Peel the plastic off the strips. Attach rigging to the top of the unit as shown, and lift with forklift or crane. Make sure that the crane or forklift is rated for the weight of the unit. Make sure that the cartridges are installed correctly in the CMAXX before rigging it to the crane or forklift. Begin to lower the unit into place. Do not set the unit down at this point. If you have a CM2 only, secure the structure to the concrete before adding the collector to the top. Line the lowest corner of the unit up with the guide pin. Continue to do this until all guide pins are aligned correctly. Do not lower the unit yet. Continue to bolt the unit to the structure. Do not tighten the bolts yet. This will allow you to adjust the unit to align all bolt holes. Make sure your alignment stickers are matching and on the same side for both your CMAXX and structure. Set the unit down completely, then tighten all the bolts. Secure the structure to the concrete. Install the discharge device under the hopper. In this video, we are installing a rhino drum. Refer to the owner's manual for instructions on attaching compressed air to the system. Refer to the manual that comes with the differential pressure kit. Make sure the tubing is correctly attached to the control board. Refer to the owner's manual for electrical diagrams. Thank you for choosing Imperial Systems. Breathe better, work safer. If you have any questions, please call us at 1-800-918-3013.